basic idea of selection sort. In each pass, select the smallest or largest element in the sublist and then move it to its proper location. First, simple selection sort. Sorting process. Scan the list and locate the smallest element and then exchange it with the first element or element at position 1. Scan the sublist from position 2 to locate the second smallest element. Exchange it with the second element or exchange it with element at position 2. Repeat. Locate the smallest element in the sublist from position I and exchange it with the ith element. Totally, n minus 1 passes should be performed. Let's see a running demo. Suppose we have 8 records to be sorted. The first stage of selection sort, index I points to position 1. We define a variable minimum points to the location of the smallest record. Suppose the first record is currently minimum. Scan from the record after 8 until the last record in the list. If element J points to is smaller, then let variable minimum points to 8 and keep moving. Compare the element's minimum point to with records J points to. If this one is smaller, minimum remains the position. J keep moving. Compare 12 and 28. 12 is smaller. J moves one position forward. Compare 12 with 31. This one is smaller. J moves forward until the last record in the list. And then we have located the smallest element. Its position variable minimum points to. Exchange the smallest element with the first element. Actually, the elements in position 1. This is the result of first stage selection. The smallest element has been selected and then exchanged to position 1. Then let's begin the second stage. Index I points to position 2. And suppose the first element in this sublist is minimum. Scan from the elements after 8. Compare. Minimum always points to currently the smallest element. If the element is bigger than element minimum points to, J moves forward. Currently, 28 is smaller than 34. Modify value of minimum. Let it point to the smallest element. And then keep moving. Compare until the last record in the list. So the smallest record in the second stage has been located. Exchange it with element in position 2. This is the result of second stage selection sort. The second smallest element has been selected and then exchanged to its proper position. Then next stage, I points to position 3. Suppose the first element in this sublist is minimum. Scan from the record after 8. If the element is smaller, minimum points to 8. Keep moving and compare, if the element j points to 8 smaller, minimum points to 8, and then keep moving and comparing until the last record has been scanned and compared. Then the smallest has been located or found. Exchange it to its proper position. For the third stage, it should be exchanged with elements in position 3. The result of the third stage selection sort, and then next stage. Index I points to position 4. Suppose this one is the smallest. Scan and compare. If the value of minimum is the same as value of index I, that means the smallest has already in its correct position. No need to exchange. Begin the next stage of selection sort. Each time we suppose the first element is the smallest, and then scan. If value of I and minimum are the same, no need to exchange. Next stage. Locate the I's smallest element and then exchange with element in position I. Next stage. We have n records to be sorted. Totally, it will be repeated n minus 1 passes or stages. Let's have a look at another example. Write result of each stage for simple selection sort. The first stage of simple selection, first locate the smallest element and then exchange with element at position 1. This is the result after the first stage of simple selection sort. Here, one thing to pay attention. We have two records with the same value of key field. After the first stage of simple selection, their positions have been exchanged. So we can judge simple selection sort is a kind of unstable sorting algorithm. And then during the second pass of selection, the second smallest element should be located and then exchanged to with the elements at position 2. And then during the third pass of selection, the third smallest element should be selected and then exchanged to its proper position. Next stage, altogether, with n records, it will be repeated n minus 1 times. Okay, let's write the algorithm together. Algorithm for selection sort. It will be repeated totally n minus 1 passes. So I vary from I to L longs minus 1. First, select locate the smallest element in that stage. And then, if it is not in its proper position, exchange with the element in position I, put it in its correct place. How to locate the smallest element? Suppose the first entry is the minimum. Scan from the records after it to the last record in the list. If the element being tracked is smaller. Remember its position. After all the records have been compared, return the location of the minimum one, and then exchange it to its correct position. Algorithm performance. Time complexity. How many records to be moved? Best case occurs if the records are given in ascending order, then no records to be moved at all. So the best case, the time number of movements is zero. Worst case, if we want to sort the elements in ascending order, unfortunately, they are given in descending order. All elements are not in its correct place, so it should be exchanged to its proper position. Totally, worst case, 3 times n minus 1 records to be moved. And number of records to be compared. Each stage, n minus I records to be compared, and totally, we need to perform n minus 1 stages. I vary from 1 to n minus 1. Totally, it's half n squared minus n. So, worst case or average case, time complexity for selection sort is linear to n squared. Space complexity. We need 1 unit to exchange 2 records, so its space complexity is constant. Selection sort is unstable. It is not considered practical or feasible for large data set. Simple selection sort can be used for linked structure. Next, let's discuss heap sort. First, let's see the definition of heap. A heap is a list of keys in which all keys have the heap property. The key at position I is smaller than key at position 2 times I and 2 times I plus 1. Then it is called a minimum heap. If key at position I is greater than or equal to key at position 2 times I and 2 times I plus 1, it is called a max heap. Based on the definition of heap, given a list, can you tell whether the list is a heap or not? Based on heap definition, compare elements at position 1 with element at position 2 and 3. This one is smaller. And then compare elements at position 2 with elements at position 4 and 5, then compare elements at position 3 with elements at position 6, 7. Next, compare elements at position 4 with elements at position 8. All nodes follow heap property, so we can say this list is a heap list. Another example. Based on heap definition, compare elements position I with elements at position 2 and 3, and then position I with position 4, 5. Next, compare elements at position 3 with elements at position 6. Then we can say this is a max heap. Do you still remember one property of a complete binary tree? It describes as follows. If a complete binary tree with n nodes is represented sequentially, then for any node with index I, we have, if I is 1, I is at the root position and has no parent. If I is greater than 1, parent I is at half I. If 2 times I is greater than n, then I has no left child. Otherwise, its left child I is at position 2 times I. The third one, if 2 times I plus 1 greater than n, then I has no right child. Otherwise, its right child is at position 2 times I plus 1. Following a property of complete binary tree, we can fill in the elements into the layout of a complete binary tree. And then to judge whether a list is a heap or not, we can compare elements with its left child and right child. So it is clear to judge whether all the nodes in the complete binary tree have the heap property. And it is very clear all the nodes follow heap property. It is a minimum heap. Another example, fill in all the records into the layout of a complete binary tree and then compare elements with its left child and right child and then judge whether this complete binary tree is a heap or not. This is a max heap. A heap has another heap property. The root of a max heap contains the largest key of all records. The root of a minimum heap contains the smallest key. For a minimum key, the key at the root position must be the smallest, while a max heap, the key at root position must be the largest one. A complete binary tree is a heap if all nodes in it have the heap property. Here is another example. Let's judge whether this complete binary tree is a heap or not. Compare record with both its children. 12 is smaller than its left child and right child. Recursively, root of this subtree smaller than both of its children. Recursively, this one smaller than both of its children. 40 smaller than its left child and also right child. Then we find a record. It is bigger than its left child and smaller than its right child. So node 27 doesn't have the heap property. And then we can say this complete binary tree is not a heap. Given a node that doesn't have the heap property, we can give it the heap property by exchanging it with its larger or smaller child. Here is an example. In the picture, the blue node 12 bigger than its left child and smaller than its right child. It doesn't have the heap property. We can exchange it with its larger child. After exchanging, the node, the blue node, has max heap property. We can also exchange it with its smaller child. After exchanging, the blue node has minimum heap property. This operation sometimes is called sifting down. One thing to notice or pay attention that after exchanging the child may have lost the hip property. Based on hip property, algorithm strategy for hip sort can be described in the following pseudocode. First, hipify the array. In other words, adjust a random list to a max heap or a minimum heap. Because of heap property, the largest or the smallest key is selected at position root. While the array isn't empty, each stage remove and replace the root, then reheap the new root node. After the root has lost heap property, reheap the list back into a heap, then the next largest or smallest key is selected. Repeat again and again until all the records are output in ascending order or in descending order. In heap sorting, we have two problems to be solved. The first one, how to turn a random list to a max or minimum heap, or how to heapify a list. The second problem, after its root has been removed, how to turn a binary tree back into a max or minimum heap. In other words, how to reheap the new root node. Let's first solve the second problem. The second problem, how to turn a binary tree back into a max or minimum heap after its root has been removed. The method is called sifting down. In the following part, we'll use a minimum heap as an example. Swap the root or the smallest item with the last node in the binary tree and remove it. To implement remove the node, we can use length of the unsorted list minus 1. Sifting down the new root to its position in the heap. If it is smaller than both of its children, break from the loop. Otherwise, exchanging it with the smaller child. Then its child may have lost heap property. Repeat until a leaf node is reached. Then a new minimum heap is built. Swap and sift down again until there is only one node left in the unsorted list. Let's see a running demo of this sifting down. Heap sort example. We are given a minimum heap. The smallest record has been selected at position root. Exchange it with the last record in the list. And this record has been put into its correct position. It will not be checked again. The size of the unsorted list minus 1. After exchanging, the root has lost the heap property. Call sift down to rebuild a new heap. Exchange the root with its smaller child. After exchanging, its child may have lost heap property. So, repeat until a leaf node is reached. 97, exchange with its smaller child. Then a new heap is built. The second smallest element has been selected at position root. Repeat, exchange it with the last record in the list. And then unsorted sublist longs minus one. This one will not be considered again. Then call shift down to rebuild a new heap. Exchange it with its smaller child. This time exchange with 38. Repeat until a leaf is reached. 97 exchange with 50. Then a new heap is built. The third smallest element has been selected at position root. Repeat again. Replace the root with the last record in the list. And then size of the unsorted list minus one. Then call shift down to rebuild a heap. Remember, the operation of shift down will repeat until a leaf node is reached. Then a new heap is built. The fourth smallest element has been selected at position root. Remove it by exchanging with last record in the list. This node will not be considered again. Then shift down. Exchange with its smaller child. And then a new heap is built. Replace it with the last record in the list. Shift down again. This operation of shifting down will be repeated until there is only one record left in the list. Then the algorithm of heap sort finish. From the animation, we can see with a minimum heap, records will be sorted in descending order. Actually, we don't use a binary linked list to represent a heap. All the operations are performed on array-based structure. Here is the running animation. Exchange the elements at the root with last record. This one will not be considered again. Then call shift down. Exchange with its little child and repeat until a leaf node is reached. A new heap, minimum heap, is built again. Remove it by exchanging with the last element in the list. The last one will not be checked again. Then shift down. This running animation to indicate all the operations actually are performed on a contiguous list or array-based list. You can perform by yourself. When there is only one record left, all the records are in descending order. Remember, with a minimum heap, the records will be sorted in descending order. Okay, let's write the algorithm together. A heap is stored in sequential list or array-based list. The function shifting down the root to rebuild a heap. Elements are stored in array I index from S to M. All the elements have the heap property except the root at position S. This function percolate down the root S and transform it into a minimum heap. First, store the root temporarily in a record, and then define an index J. First, point to its left child, and we only track the elements within the range of the array. And then compare its left child and right child. Index J points to its smaller child. Compare the root with its smaller child. If it is smaller than both of its children, terminate repetition, break from the for loop, and stop. Otherwise, swap with its smaller child and then move down. Repeat until a leaf node is reached and then insert the root to its correct position. Let's check the first problem, how to turn a random list into a minimum heap or how to heapify a list. Array of n records is represented in layout of a complete binary tree. All leaf nodes automatically have the heap property. Work from the last non-leaf node, its index is half n, down to the first node. Call sifdown for each record to give it heap property. Build a heap from the bottom up by successively sifting downwards to establish the heap property. Here is an example. Given a random list, from node index half n to the first node, call sifdown to initially build a minimum heap. In this layout of a complete binary tree, leaf nodes automatically have a heap property. Begin from the last non-leaf record, its index is half n, and then call sifdown to give it heap property. Exchange with its smaller child. Then this node has heap property. Upward, node 65 exchange with its smaller child to give it minimum heap property. Next, 38, it is smaller than both of its children, so it has heap property. Until the first node is percolate, exchange with its smaller child. After exchanging, the child may have lost heap property, so sifdown will continue until a leaf node is reached. 49, sifdown, exchange with smaller child, and then a minimum heap is built. Actually, all the operations are performed on a contiguous list. All the operations are performed on array. This one is the last non-leaf node. Sifdown, exchange with its smaller children. Next one, exchange with its smaller children. This one, compare with left child and right child. It is smaller. No need to sifdown. And finally, the first record, compare and exchange continue until a leaf node is reached and a heap is built. Let's write the algorithm together. First, heapify a random list from the last non-leaf node up to the first node. Call sift_down for each item to give it heap property. After this for loop, initially a minimum heap is constructed and the smallest element is selected at position root, or in other words, at position 1. And then exchange the root with the last record in the sublist. The root has lost its heap property. From the root to the last record in the unsorted sublist, call sift_down to rebuild a new heap. This will be repeated n-1 times. All the records in the list will be sorted in descending order if we build a minimum heap. Let's analyze algorithm performance. Time complexity. To transform a random list into a heap will cost linear time. Time complexity of sifting down is logarithm n and be called n times. Therefore, the performance of this algorithm is linear logarithm n. Even in worst case, its time complexity is linear to n logarithm n. Space complexity. One unit should be used to exchange two records, so time complexity is constant. Heap sort is a kind of unstable sorting algorithm, and it is suitable for large data set. It is unstable. Let's give an example. We are given a random list. With this random list, to build a max heap, to heapify a max heap. Begin with last non-leaf record. In this example, last non-leaf record is 41. Then exchange with its smaller, a larger child. And then next one, 72, exchange with its larger child. And then 86, this one is bigger than its left and right child. No need to sit down. And the last one, the first record, to give it max heap property, exchange with 93. Don't forget, this will repeat until a leaf node is reached. So 50 has to be exchanged with 72. Then a max heap is constructed. Write them in the sequence of initial max heap. Pay attention. We have two records with the same value of keywords. This is its initial position. After a max heap is constructed, their position are interchanged. So heap sort is a kind of unstable sorting algorithm. Let's check. If we want to build a minimum heap, begin from the last non-leaf record, 41, because it is smaller, So no need to exchange. Next one, 72. Exchange with its smaller child. Next one, 86. Exchange with its smaller child, 41. Continue. Exchange with its smaller child, 45. And then for the first record, to build a minimum heap, sifting down. Exchange with its smaller child, 41. Repeat. Exchange with its smaller child. And then a minimum heap is constructed from top to bottom on each level from left to right. Write the sequence of initial minimum heap. And from this example, we can see heap sort is unstable sorting algorithm. Okay, so much for heap sort and so much for selection sorting algorithm.